A ventilator-induced lung injury is an acute injury to the lungs that occurs while a patient is receiving mechanical ventilatory support. It is caused by the mechanical forces associated with positive pressure mechanical ventilation, which can cause damage to lung tissue. The two types of ventilator-induced lung injuries include barotrauma and volutrauma. Barotrauma is caused by high airway pressures that can cause a rupture of the alveoli or bronchi. Similarly, volutrauma is caused by high volumes of air being forced into small airways, which can cause lung tissue to stretch and damage. The symptoms of a ventilator-induced lung injury range from mild dyspnea or shortness of breath to severe respiratory distress. The longer a patient is on mechanical ventilation, the greater their chances are of experiencing this type of injury. A patient at risk of a ventilator-induced lung injury may benefit from lung protective strategies, such as smaller tidal volumes, low plateau pressures, low driving pressures, appropriate FiO2, and appropriate levels of PEEP. These strategies are often used in patients with acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is a disorder characterized by refractory hypoxemia, decreased lung compliance, and severe oxygen insufficiency. Ventilator-induced lung injuries are primarily caused by an increased transpulmonary pressure during positive pressure ventilation. This pressure is the difference between alveolar pressure and pleural pressure. When the transpulmonary pressure is increased, it can cause alveolar rupture and collapse of lung tissue. This explains why clinicians concluded that a lower transpulmonary pressure is associated with a lower risk of ventilator-induced lung injuries. To be more specific about the lung protective strategies, you should strive to keep the patient's tidal volume within a range of 4 to 8 milliliters per kilogram. You should try to keep their plateau pressure less than 28. Their driving pressure less than 15, and you should strive to use an FiO2 that will maintain their PaO2 between 55 and 80 millimeters of mercury. And the same goes for an FiO2 to maintain the SpO2 between 88 to 95%. You should also strive to avoid patient ventilator desynchrony, auto-PEEP, and air trapping. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.